Recognize the gentleman from Maryland, Mr. Sarbanes, for 4 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, Mr. Zuckerberg. I wanted to get something in the record quickly before I move to some questions. You had suggested in your testimony over the last couple of days that Facebook notified the Trump and Clinton campaigns of Russian attempts to hack in to those campaigns, but representatives of both campaigns in the last 24 hours have said that didn't happen. So we're going to need to follow up on that and find out what the real story is.
Do you want me to?
No, I'd like to move on. You can provide a response to that in writing if you would. Let me ask you, is it true that Facebook offered to provide what I guess you refer to as dedicated campaign embeds to both of the presidential campaigns?
Congressman, I can quickly respond to the first point, too.
Just say yes or no. Were there embeds? I need to get to that because I don't have time. Were there embeds in the two campaigns? Were offers of embeds?
Congressman,
yes or no?
Were there
embeds offered to the Trump campaign and the Clinton campaign?
We offer sales support to every campaign.
Okay, so sales support, I'm going to refer to that as embeds. And I gather that Mr. Trump's campaign ultimately accepted that offer. Is that correct? Yes or no?
Congressman, the Trump campaign had sales support. And
okay, so they had embeds. I'm going to refer to those as embeds. What I'd like you to do, if you could, we're not going to have time for you to do this now, but if you could provide to the committee both the initial offer terms and then any subsequent offer terms that were presented to each candidate in terms of what the embed services would be, that would be very helpful. Do you know how many ads were approved for display on Facebook for each of the presidential candidates by Facebook?
Congressman, I do not, sitting here off the top of my head.
Okay, let me tell you what they were, because I do. President Trump's campaign had an estimated 5.9 million ads approved, and Secretary Clinton, 66,000 ads. So that's a delta of about 90 times as much on the Trump campaign, which raises some questions about whether the ad approval processes were maybe not processed correctly or inappropriately bypassed in the final months and weeks of the election by the Trump campaign. And what I'm worried about is that the embeds may have helped to facilitate that. Can you say with absolute certainty that Facebook or any of the Facebook employees working as campaign embeds did not grant any special approval rights to the Trump campaign to allow them to upload a very large number of Facebook ads in that final stretch?
Congressman, we apply the same standard to all campaigns.
Can you say that there were not special approval rights granted? Is that what you're saying? There were not special approval rights granted by any of the embeds or support folks, as you call them, in that Trump campaign?
Congressman,
yes or no?
what I'm saying is that
you would, all right, if you're saying yes, if you're saying yes, then I'll take you at your word. The reason this is important and the reason we need to get to the bottom of it is because it could be a serious problem if these kinds of services were provided beyond what is offered in the normal course, because that could result in violation of campaign finance law, because it would be construed as an in-kind contribution, corporate contribution from Facebook, beyond what the sort of ad-buy opportunity would typically provide. The reason I'm asking you these questions is because I'm worried that that embed program has the potential to become a tool for Facebook to solicit favor from policymakers, and that then creates the potential for real conflict of interest. And I think a lot of Americans are waking up to the fact that Facebook is becoming sort of a self-regulated superstructure for political discourse. And the question is, are we, the people, going to regulate our political dialogue, or are you, Mark Zuckerberg, going to end up regulating the political discourse?
Gentlemen's,
so we need to be free of that undue influence. I thank you for being here.
Gentlemen's time
yield
expired.
Back
Chair recognizes gentleman from Texas, Mr. Olson, for
Mr.
4 minutes.
Mr. Chairman, do you mind for the record if I just answer the first point for
That's fine.
Take 10
Go
seconds.
Ahead.
When I was referring to the campaigns yesterday, I meant the DNC and RNC. So I may have misspoken, and maybe technically that's called the committees, but those were the folks who I was referring to.
Thank you for that clarification.